Would you like an English country garden? Well, do you need to live in the English countryside to have an English country garden? It's Alexandra here from the Middlesized Garden with Middlesized Garden of the Month. And today, on this rather blowy January day, I'm talking to Kylie O'Brien about her middle-sized country garden. It's a beautiful English country garden. If you really do have a country garden, you're going to have a lot of challenges from the weather. So I'm going to ask Kylie how she deals with those. And I'm also going to ask Kylie what the essential ingredients are for an English country garden. So even if you live in a town and you don't even live in Britain, you can replicate some of her gorgeous garden ideas.
Well, the main challenge was that there was virtually nothing here. And we have a very brisk southwesterly wind to contend with. Hedges.
So you put hedges in?
Yep. Hedges all the way down the side, all the way along the back. And I got those bare rooted. So this happened over a series of winters. And they're all natural hedges because I'm quite keen on wildlife. Then I put in hornbeam hedges crossways as a series of barriers against the wind. And gradually over the years, they've begun to work. Yeah. One advantage of doing things quite slowly is that, of course, things gradually grow and require less maintenance. And so it was a lot of hard work to begin with. And that was a good 10 years ago. Now, of course, it's just a matter of keeping things trimmed. The key ingredients of an English garden, I think, is a certain relaxed look, which, of course, is very good for us who don't have much time. I think looking at a certain kind of planting using lavenders and those traditional style plants, I think an ease with the landscape as well is a very English thing. And there's a certain English romance, I think. It's hard to put your finger on it, but those sorts of plants that look good even when they're falling over, and you think of tumbling roses and so on. My advice for anyone keeping hens in the garden is the two of them do not go together. Let's face it, hens will destroy a garden if you give them enough time. So keep them caged up or locked up for most of the time, and then let them have a run where they can go into the beds. What's hugely important to me about this garden is that it works all winter long, and I love to look at it from the garden room. So we start with the sundial and bits of topiary, and then a little hedge just beyond made out of yew, which I keep clipped the whole time, and then expands out to what really is the most glorious skyline, with a little bit of vigour given by the trees. And that's really, I guess, what I'm most proud of in making the garden. I think the best way to find a style that suits you is to look at gardens and visit them and see other people.
Kylie's low-clipped hedges not only protect the garden from the wind, but also give beautiful winter structure. Another good tip for busy gardeners is that she grows a lot of what are called species plants, or plants that are as close to their wild form as possible. Very roughly speaking, plants which have names at the end like Cotswold Beauty are often cultivated forms of a more natural plant. Some cultivars are created to be hardy and easy to grow, but if you don't know a great deal about plants, it's often best to go for tried and tested species plants like Rosa rugosa, Verbascum and Primula vulgaris, all of which Kylie grows. Ask your local plant nursery about this, rather than necessarily always buying the latest new floral introduction. Join us on the first Saturday of every month for a tour of the Middlesized Garden of the Month, where we will tour beautiful middle-sized gardens you probably wouldn't otherwise see. The Middlesized Garden YouTube channel also has regular top tips, reviews and more, so do subscribe. There are links in the description below. And if you like this garden, hit like or let me know what sort of gardens you'd like me to feature by leaving a comment in the description below. Thank you.